It's
true. Can we start? Nobody can do us.
We haven't left yet.
Knackers, it's crap.
Sure up.
Always wanted to get up on this stage. Always wanted to come up here and say, Knackers! Are we doing this play or what? Is that when Miss Hudson gets you in office all neat and smelling of perfume and she says, you don't come to school to mess around, to waste time. We treat you like young adults and we expect you to behave accordingly. I don't think that writing on a wall is a mature thing to do.
That's good, that's salty. Just like her.
Yeah, but really, all she wants to say is, oi, salty, pack all this graffiti and it's getting on my knackers. I'm starting. Anyway, why am I bothered? No more school, no more stick, no more teachers thinking that you're thick, no more Miss Judge shouting at you like you're deaf as a doorpost. Gail Saunders, how dare you vouch in front of me? Sorry, Miss, didn't realise it's your turn.
Brilliant.
No more full school assemblies sitting on the cold floor of the sports hall freezing your knackers off.
No more cross country running. Freezing cold. Showers and towels that don't dry you.
Oh, and then what scenes in the change rooms? Where you then get changed in front of everyone because you wear a vest and everyone else has got a bra.
No more Mr. Thorne sending letters home about how I miss games and we're sitting eating a kebab in spoons.
No more job teachers with thrill cream push puppies. No more trendy art teachers who say, hiya and call me Gordon.
We ain't had an art teacher called Gordon.
I know. And never have to do the 1500 metres or with a heart condition. No more!
Because today we're off, skiving it forever.
Let's start something. Hang on. Before we do start, we'd all like to say a big thank you to Mr. Harrison, our drama teacher.
Before he came to this school 6 months ago, us three didn't do sod all. Not a thing. He got us into this. He's a good bloke.
You are, sir. I know he's been offered a job at a Baker school. Well, good luck to him. Before Mr. Harrison came here, the teachers had left us here for dead.
We were average.
Girl was stabbed to an earth and fights when cornered. Average. Well, I don't feel average today. I feel top of the class.
I never thought we'd be doing this. I hated drama, I only took it for a doss.
Right, don't forget to stay in character and Pommy! Always face the front.
I will do.
And speak up! Now, a lot of stuff in this play was told to us by Mr. Harrison. And though you might not believe it, everything that was in this play is based on truth.
But the names and faces have been changed to protect the innocent.
We take you to Whitewall High School. It's a comprehensive school somewhere in England, and they're expecting a new teacher to arrive.
There's 1,500 kids at Whitehall, and it's a special priority area, which means it's got its fair share of problems.
All we want you to do is use your imagination, because there's only three of us, and we've all got and narrators.
So you'll have to concentrate.
Oh yeah, you'll have to concentrate. Title? Oh shit, yeah! And it's called Teachers. Morning. Stop running, Simon Patterson. Morning, Tim.
Morning, Mr. Bashford.
Morning, Roy. Morning, Mrs. Pally. Good morning. You are chewy, girl. Spit it out. Now go into my hair, into the bin!
I don't call it straight line, do you, Claire Dickinson? No! Neither do I! Yes, I know that was the bell, Simon Patterson! The bell is a signal for me to move and nobody else! Hi, I'm Jeff Nixon, the new drama teacher. I'm looking for Mrs. Parry's office.
Up the stairs in the nice park stall on the left. Drama teacher. He looks like
I knew at my interview that Whitehall had a bad reputation and no drama facilities. But, like a sheriff with my new degree pinned to my chest, I bound up to Mrs. Parry's office, but she was busy with Mr. Basford, the deputy head.
I can't believe you're doing this!
I run it, and I shall do what I like.
After all the work I put in, turn around and you tell me I'm not Coco! Bring it to the bloody liberty!
Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Basford, but there really is nothing I can do. I simply need a younger person. I'm sure you'll have a great deal of fun in the court.
In the court? I wouldn't be seen dead in the corner.
Well, it's that or nothing. Good day. I have another appointment. Mr. Nixon, Jeff Nixon.
That's right.
Hello, nice to see you again. Coffee.
Please.
Mrs. Parry's office was a cavern of theatre posters. She certainly had more than a passing interest.
Drama, bare boards, and passion. This is my all-male production of the Trojan Women. And this is me as Ophelia.
Behind her head was a photo of a much lither Mrs. Parry in an amateur production of Hamlet.
We're doing the Mikado in the spring term, Mr. Nixon.
I knew exactly what she meant.
I'm looking for Okay.
It must be difficult.
Mr. Basford usually takes the lead in our local GNS productions, but I'm afraid he was rather tiresome last year in The Pirates. We're looking for new blood. Well, that's giving you something to think about, hasn't it?
It certainly has.
And so to business, Mr. Nixon.
The interview went on for another 20 minutes, but I got the message. Keep an eye out for the teacher-eating girls and the thuggish boys. They'll eat you for breakfast.
The one thing he did notice about Mrs. Parry, she really did care about the kids at Whitehall.
As we walked from my office, that is Mrs. Parry's, I wished Jeff all the luck in his probationary year and took him towards Mr. Baxter's room, home of the timetable. Here we are!
The gigantic timetable was screwed to the wall. It was so colourful, so meticulous. It was like a work of art, like something out of the Vatican. A life's work had gone into creating it.
The nomenclature is fairly straightforward. You will be N.I., Mr. Nixon, and drama will be D.R. Drama lessons with you will take place in the main hall, so a lesson would read N.I.D.I.M.H. and a first year class would be N.I.D.I.M.H.I.Y.X. Period 1, fairly simple.
Elementary, Mrs. Parry.
I'm always available. And don't forget about the Mikado. The theatre is in your blood. This could be your big break.
So I tentatively said, yes, to the small part in the chorus. And though Mrs. Parry was disappointed that I didn't win Coco, she said I would certainly enjoy my time in Titty Poo.
Jupiter!
Eh?
Sarah Moss?
Well, where should you be?
Sarah, I don't know. I've got my girl on my timetable. So, I'm in tutor group ID, but I'm in teacher group IY5, and I should be in block 43B doing history, but Mr. D is in there with 3YY6 doing biology. He says that I should be in block 31B, but I've been there and the class is empty, so I'll be looking for my class for 40 minutes.
Do you know where you're meant to be?
Peeing the gym.
Right. Well, then I suggest you go and wait there, and then at least your class will find you.
Thanks, sir.
Oh, before we go, do you have any idea where 9IB is? When you're an Ardner and 15, giving the teacher a bad time is part of the rules of the game. In our class, weird enough, three tutors in as many weeks.
There was Miss Bell, who had a nervous breakdown, but said she was pregnant.
Then we had that supply ginger, who was always crying.
And then we said it's old Mr. Wilcox, who was Jeff's mouth of that.
Now! They've sent us a new teacher, a brand new, sparkling clean, straight out of the box teacher.
They're only going to be in school for two more terms. Send that new bloke Nixon. He can cut his teeth down in 7YY. If they burn him or skin him alive, we can forget about it.
In 7YY, there was me, Salty, Gail and Toby, who you know, Kevin Mears, who spoke funny. All right, Kevin?
Not bad, Salty, all right. I've been down to our Malcolm's house. He's got a brilliant BMX. We had a great game of rallycross.
Kevin was 15 going on 3. There was Jeff Froggett, who never wore any decent shoes.
Sally Renshaw.
Vicky Marshall.
Walter Jones.
That's the girl in a kid wall.
Oh, Trisha Forshaw had been through nearly all the kids in school except me.
Salty, that's not true.
It is!
It's not.
Right, you asked any good.
When asked any good what time was, the big mouth.
Oh, can we get on with it?
And there was Trisha Forshaw, who was known.
But it might not be true.
I've been bit
slack.
It's better.
When they sent you a new teacher, it was like getting some foster parents. By the time Nixon arrived, us three were bored and disinterested. Hi, is this 9IB? I'm Mr. Nixon. If you two lads could just come down off the bookshelf, I don't think they were designed for sitting on, were they? If you just come down! If you could stop playing table tennis, that would also help. Oh, if everyone could just sit on a chair and not on a desk. Right, that's better. My name is Mr. Nixon. The entire class burst into laughter. I didn't see that I'd said anything particularly funny. My name's fairly straightforward, and I've only got one head. So I turned to look at the blackboard and saw that some joker had drawn an enormous pair of genitals on the board. I turned to the class, who were still laughing. Bollocks is not spelt with an X.